Welcome back, guys. Last episode we added some folds to the robes and to the chainmail underneath the robes. Just getting a bit of definition there. We may want to just smooth that out there. Didn't look that good. So from now we're going to grab the pants, and we're going to do the same thing to the pants, really. Let's turn off the chainmail shirt and turn off the robes. I want to keep the boots there for now. We can turn the belt off. Let's have a look at these pants here. So we basically want them... They're gonna come off up a bit. So let's get these pants and extrude them. So your Z modeler brush, and I'll just make that process a bit smaller. Hit the extrude all polygons. Let's take away there. Now that's gone through the boots. That looks I might just, before I do that, quickly deform it. So you know how we've been inflating it? Let's just inflate it backwards. So we're gonna just push it in a bit. So so what will happen when we inflate it now, it's going to come out. I think I want a bit more depth than that. And then that should not interfere too much down here. But we're going to reform these boots a bit more better later as well. They're still in their basic shape. So yeah, once we've done that, let's go to solo and I want to see if I can... just cut that out. Doesn't like me doing that, does it? Yeah. Alright. We're going to just export it out just like that to 3D code. So you'll find that, like I said, I do this quite often, and it just makes it so much easier for me to perform functions that I need. Open the trousers. Okay. Let's find this inside layer. That's one. We can delete that. That's another. We can delete that. That should be the outside layer there. Yep, that looks fine there. We don't need that. That other bit. We can just have them at the top. The other ones down the bottom aren't going to show that much. Okay, so we just want to re-add those edge loops back in. So I'm going to just start with, go there and there. That should be even. Are they even? It's there and there. Going to add one into the pants, probably that one. Maybe even go this one. Alright, and that's on there. Let's add. Alright, here we can just get rid of that one. So over this side, we just need that one there. That looks fine, I believe. Let's give it a edge loops unwrap. Yeah, it looks like a pretty good mesh there. So let's just pack the UV. It's going to turn it around. Yep. So I swing that back around and put it back down where it was because we want them in the same direction. Let's export the retro project trousers to ZBrush. Just overwrite them. And remember, when importing the back in after you've done the UVs, go to polygroups, auto with UVs, most similar. Okay. Now we have the mesh. Let's get back to the character. It's there. What we want to do is grab some of those fold brushes that we had previously. There's one here that's for the kneecap as well, so let's reduce that down and see how it looks here. Bring that back up a bit. If you want it upside down a bit. So bring it in, make it upside down. Okay, that's probably okay there. I'm going to grab some other, we want this little brush here. Let's add. Let's see if the sub works any better there. You could probably go with the sub because we've got a bit of room to move there. Sort of get the mesh going in those creased areas. Around the back side, we've got some creasing about there. Also, you don't want symmetry on all of it. So, at the back of the knees here, let's add something here. Another one there. Might add something on the side here. So like, and then in here. There and there maybe. Some folds. The pants don't. We don't have our Templar walking around with ironed clothes. Just put them in. So basically, just roughing up the pants. Let's move those boots because we may want to just quickly give a little bit of wrinkles down here. See, that's good because it's also pulling that closer to the skin there. Now we've got some creased pants. Grab your move brush and we want to just do what we did before and just move the mesh over so it's covering the, we don't want the underneath of the legs to show. All your mesh needs to sit on the outside or else you'll have conform issues later. These brush tools are amazing. I was very happy when I found them. they just take a lot of work out. Also, I don't work in you know, the high poly to low poly modeling. Some people do. That's their preference. So I want to show you that if we go to your geometry and add some first I want to save this just in case something happens. So I want Z project Templar. Save the file here as Templar. I'm gonna just divide that to 3, 4. So it's got very high subdivision level there. When you have these brushes selected, you will see a lot more detail in the brushes, in those folds. Yeah, like that one's the kneecap area. Grab the other. So this one's the back brush. As you can notice, they really, really brings out those the texture there. So if you are working with your low poly to high poly, these brushes obviously will do a very good job. The one going in now, let's add that one out. You can see the detail in these brushes. It's pretty damn good. But yeah. I don't work that way. This just the low poly to high poly is good enough. The low poly to me is good enough. I was adding the. There we go. Just adding the textures and stuff afterwards. ZBrush allows you to get some extra depth in there as well. Sorry, substance painter. Let's move. Okay. Let's have a look how that looks. Like, also, you may want to add more polys in there. You can add, like, actual more detailed folds in there. But you'll have to just add a few more polys in there to do that. Let's see how these look now with the boots on. It's fine. We'll pull the boots out after that. The robe. See, with the robe on, you're obviously not going to see much. But if you're just using the using it with the shirt, the chainmail shirt there, you can just I might just grab that chainmail shirt as well. I'll just bring that out a little bit around these sections. The sections that we've got a bit of poke through there. With the pants, that is. So, that looks alright. Let's probably go in here a bit. Now with the robe, if there's any other poking through from the channel underneath, just fix that up as well. But that looks pretty good. So as you can see, the pants. Definitely give them a bit more definition there. We'll also be adding some extra fold layers from through Substance Painter as well to give that a lot more detail. But that's the pants for now. See you next video.